I feel like I can already spot some terrorist infrastructure, though. I don't think this is... Let's picture those lights.
Probably yeah.
Like super high voltage.
Well, the lights are there so that the terrorists can spot the big, beautiful, brave IDF vegan soldiers from afar and then take pot shots with a sniper rifle.
Will Israel retaliate?
This is Israel-Palestine drama.
Yeah.
I love using neutral language like they're cops, you know, when like police shootings happen, when like police murder someone.
Yeah.
And they're like, lethal strike was facilitated and, you know, projectile bullets were flying and made contact with a person. And it's like, well, what happened there, you know? And they're basically talking about it in the same terms whenever they...
launched it. You don't know what's...
Israel launches lethal strike on Jenin.
Palestinians call it a new war crime against...
That's why they just got their new... They just got their new drones.
Yeah.
...for defenseless people. The Palestinian Health Ministry says at least 8 people have been killed, with that number likely to rise, and at least 50 others now injured. Israel says it hit terrorist infrastructure in the densely populated...
Yeah, Israel always says that, bro. That really doesn't mean anything.
Whatever terrorist infrastructure is.
Yeah. I mean, they said that when they hit the Associated Press building, okay? Like, the notion that, like, Israel is hitting terrorist structure is just anywhere where there are brown people, Israel considers terrorist structures. Full Netanyahu? Wait, no shot did they bring Netanyahu up. I can't do this. I'm not going to watch this. I'm going to... Oh my God, I'm not watching this. There's no way. No. Oh God, liberals are so gross. They use any and every opportunity to rehabilitate a psychotic war criminal like Netanyahu. They're like, oh man, like there wasn't another Jewish person you could have had on. It had to be Netanyahu, really?
Kanye West has said, I'm a bit sleepy tonight, but when I wake up, I'm going DEFCON 3 on Jewish people. Will Israel retaliate?
You know, anti-Semitism is the longest hatred in history. It goes back thousands of years. We've dealt with bigger problems than these stupidities. But, you know, the communists blame the Jews for being capitalists. The capitalists blame the Jews for being communists. You have a problem, blame the Jews. It's old stuff. It shouldn't have any place in civilized discourse. And that's the reason we established...
The communists blame the Jews for being capitalists. What? Wait, what? Why did you just say that? Why did he start off with that? No, it's usually just the opposite. What? The most famous example of anti-Semitic hatred is quite literally the Nazis, which, by the way, this man very famously minimized the genuine anti-Semitism of. Like, if you're thinking about, like, a guy who is probably the worst person to speak on anti-Semitism, like, Bibi Netanyahu is one of those people, okay? Straight up. Famously, Bibi Netanyahu unironically stated such profoundly awful things that he got widespread condemnation from a big chunk of the Jewish community, where he famously said Hitler wasn't individually anti-Semitic. He was convinced by the Palestinian Arabs to be anti-Semitic, like, which is just a revision, which is a Holocaust revision, okay? Straight up.
Hitler didn't want to exterminate the Jews at the time. He wanted to expel the Jews. And Khaja Amin al-Husseini went to Hitler and said, if you expel them, they'll all come here. So what should I do with them? He asked. He said, burn them.
He said that. This man's on some other shit.
The Jewish state, so the Jewish people would have defense against these absurdities. And sometimes they're coupled with violence. We don't let that happen again.
Okay, oh my God. Liberals clapping for Bibi Netanyahu, who is not even popular in Israel, bro.
For multiple nights a week this month, thousands of Israelis have marched to the Prime Minister's official residence.
I want you to hear me, our Prime Minister. You disappoint me very, very much. And I was your number one fan.
That's crazy.
I just want to read a few quotes from American congressmen, just to Congress people, rather, just to show that Kanye West's comment is not really out of order with some things that are said by people in more official positions. Here's one. Israel has hypnotized the world. May Allah awaken the people and help them see the evil doings of Israel. 10 years ago, if you read that to me, I thought that...
Trump. No, Ilhan Omar.
That would be from Hezbollah. That's an American congressperson. Another American congressperson says the reality of Israel's apartheid government, goes on to say the occupation and ethnic cleansing Palestinians live with every day. Another one says Israel targets media sources so the world can't see Palestinians being massacred. I have three questions.
Wait, what? What is he, like, doing two truths and a lie or something? Like, I don't get it. Ilhan Omar's original statement about, like, the hypnotization, saucy. Not good. Straight up. I'll say it. But the rest are just genocide denial. That's crazy. The rest are just Bill Maher being like, I don't agree with what they're saying about Israel. Which is f***ed up. Like, they literally blew up the Associated Press building inside of Gaza, man. What?
For you. Are you massacring Palestinians? Are you ethnic cleansing and are you an apartheid state?
Why is Bill Maher doing this? Like, I mean, I get why. He's such a piece of shit. But it is uniquely surprising that Mr. Religulous is over here defending like this religious theocratic apartheid state.
No, no, and no. I mean, these are all ridiculous.
Dude, what the clapping for this shit too. That's crazy, man. That's actually wild.
Charges against the one democracy in the Middle East, the one democracy that upholds human rights, that defends freedom, and is America's best ally. So I think these people should wake up to reality, but I think that's too great a hope. It's not going to happen. We just have to defend ourselves against these people because they purvey lies. You ever hear the word fake news? This is fake old news. It goes back thousands of years. We're not impressed by it.
Okay. But could you...
What the f***? Bro, this is a bananas f***ing take, man.
That's insane. That's crazy. Like, anti-Semitism impacts all Jews, okay? That's wild. There are plenty of other Jewish people that you could have pulled from to talk about anti-Semitism, okay? Not Netanyahu, okay? Oh, my Lord, dude.
How can you praise Hitler? Hitler was the greatest mass killer of all time, so anybody who praises him is wrong. Anybody who meets with him and gives it legitimacy is wrong.
Yeah, Chuck should be like, hey, you know what's really crazy, though? Remember when you did Holocaust revisionism and said Hitler actually didn't hate the Jews all that much until the Palestinian mufti taught him to hate the Jews? Like, he wasn't even planning on killing all the Jews? People always, whenever I bring this up, people are like, there's no shot he said that. Yeah, he did, okay? He did. Netanyahu is a very bad guy, okay? Very, very, very bad guy.
I'm waiting for Israel to finally come out and be like, listen, of course we're going to keep hitting children because, like, the Palestinian age demographic is just too low.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Israelis, he's doing Sigma face. Israeli military saying that they're going into the West Bank to try to prevent militants from being able to later carry out attacks. But it just seems to be perpetuating the cycle of violence. And we have been reporting it seemingly time and time again about how everything we're seeing is once again reminiscent of the days of the Second Intifada when Israeli tanks were seen in the actual cities themselves in the West Bank. But really, today is something new because it's been confirmed now from an Israeli military source telling CNN that this is the largest Israeli military operation in the West Bank since 2002. When you look at just the full number of soldiers, hundreds of Israeli soldiers, the fact that they were using airstrikes from drones, we know of at least 10 airstrikes that were being...
It's wild saying, like, cycle of violence and shit, because, like, in every sense of the word, it's like going to a kindergarten and slaughtering them with an AR-15, and you're, like, fully kitted out, okay? And then the kindergartners throw rocks at you, and retaliation in the cycle of violence. Now, some of you might say, well, Hassan, Palestinians are fully grown adults and human beings. Like, how dare you rid them of autonomy and treat them like they're kindergartners? No, literally. Some of the fucking kids, a lot of them, are kindergartners that are getting fucking blown to bits because in Gaza and even in the West Bank now, anywhere where there are Palestinians that remain, their average age is insanely low. You guys want to know why that is the case? And most importantly, this used to be Gaza, okay? The world's largest open air prison where I forget what the average age is, but they've already massacred the able-bodied men. So of course, what remains are fucking children.
The Gaza Strip is only 25 miles long and about 5 miles wide. 2 million Palestinians live packed into this tiny space, one of the most densely populated places in the world. Half are children. Many live in refugee camps speckled throughout the besieged territory. A stunning 80% of the population relies on foreign aid. Aptly called an open-air prison, there are only two ways to leave the enclosed area: the Erez crossing into Israeli territory and the Rafah crossing, which goes to Egypt. Both are completely controlled by hostile militaries. What Israel calls a border is actually a heavily militarized perimeter fence comprised of barbed wire, surveillance networks, and lethal no-go zones. If you roam too close to the so-called no-go zone, which extends 300 meters out from the fence, Israeli forces have authorized themselves to shoot to kill. Thousands of unarmed Palestinians have been shot for violating this rule in 2018 alone.
Now they're doing it in occupied West Bank. I'm old enough to remember that occupied West Bank and the encroachment in the form of settler colonial terrorism was actually seen as an objectively evil thing that Israel was not even openly advocating for, but even in some instances openly saying that it was wrong. They would be like, these bulldozers, I mean, I don't know how they got there, but like, of course we would never supply infrastructural and military support to them, to very quickly being like, oh no, we're making the entirety of West Bank into a parking lot where we are purposely, strategically blowing through Palestinian neighborhoods in an effort to set up additional checkpoints in between them and make lives completely unhabitable for Palestinians living on Palestinian soil that Israel has no fucking business being there. I mean, they don't have any business being in the entirety of fucking Palestine, but let's be real, especially so even from like the most liberal, progressive perspective, right? And yet here we are. The median age in Gaza is 18 and the West Bank median age is 21.9. Yeah.
You got something to say?
No.
Good.
Being carried out in Jenin, when you look at the bulldozers that are tearing up streets on the streets of Jenin. Now, Israeli military saying this is being done to try.
Any kind of coverage on this matter that doesn't reflect the reality that I just described to you, which is an apartheid regime set up by an apartheid regime with the express purpose of creating a religious ethno state, okay, a theocratic ethno state. Anyone that does not explain it on such terms is lying to you. They're whitewashing genocide. Western media is absolutely doing this, okay? 100%.
These are not scenes that we are used to seeing here, at least not since the days of the Second Intifada. And Paula, this is ongoing.
They called it a military operation. This is how Russia talks about Ukraine. Yeah. Yeah, it's just a military operation.
Still getting reports.
Except Israel is like significantly more successful than Russia is. Let's be real, because Ukraine is backed by the Western powers. Israel also backed by the Western powers. In a conflict like this, the party that is backed by Western powers is always going to have some level of upper hand. I mean, in the Ukraine situation, at least it's like even the playing field. I think in a serious way. But in the Israel Palestine situation, it's just like incredible. You're using the most advanced weapons on people who literally don't have water.
97% of the fresh water in Gaza is toxic. The vast majority of Gaza's water desalination plants, which produce fresh water, were destroyed or damaged by Israeli bombs and cannot operate. Fixing them requires importing materials banned by the blockade. Over 25% of all diseases in Gaza are directly caused by contaminated water. This alone makes conditions dire, but the near total absence of electricity makes quality of life border on impossible.
بالنسبة للكهرباء احنا بنعاني منها والله بنعاني منها اكترية اليوم بتبقى قاطعة الكهرباء بتجينا 4 ساعات وباقي النهار بتبقى قاطعة 20 ساعة 16 ساعة بتبقى قاطعة ويعني نحن عارفين نتلج مية ولا عارفين نجيب أكل زي الناس، يعني أكترية الأكل تبعنا بيخرب بضمن قطع الكهرباء. أصلاً النفس اللي بنتنفسه هو الكهرباء. وبنخاف برضه، خطورته كبيرة، يعني لو أي ولد بلا ما خذ مسك شمعة وحرق الدار حطها في الأواعي بتنحرق. أنا بالنسبة لطموحاتي، طموحاتي في هالحياة كثير. طموحاتي أن يكون عندي دخل، أني أعلم أولادي وبناتي في المدارس وأعيشهم أحلى عيشة. نفسي بلم أخذي يكون يجي يوم أني أفرح فيه، بل بيجي كل يوم، بيجي يوم عن يوم أسوأ من يوم اللي بجيه للأسف. إيش نسوي؟ هذا الحصار دمر غزة، دمرنا والله، دمرنا.
Their water supply is completely controlled by the people using the advanced military war machine, you know?
Now, we are hearing that at least 8 Palestinians have been killed. There have been some reports that some of them at least are militants, but no militant group has claimed them yet as their own. We know of at least 50 who have been injured. One Israeli soldier has been injured as well. But of course, for the civilians there, I was actually just in Jenin yesterday on the ground talking.
Mom, I wonder what happened. Did one of the IDF guys stub their toe?
Yeah, they got to be pretty incompetent to get injured in this situation.
It's like we talked about the American war machine in Iraq and Afghanistan. If there's one group of occupying forces that are directly doing even worse kinds of warfare, like disproportionate use of force against enemy combatants that are literally civilians with nothing, it's the Israeli occupying force against random Palestinian 14-year-olds, okay? Tripped over a dangerous rock. It's like, dude, you are one of the most geared occupying force on the planet. It would literally be like, it'd be like if the American militarized police force was like literally going into a kindergarten and just like slaughtering everyone, okay? They would like drive the fucking APC.
I feel like I can already spot some terrorist infrastructure though. I don't think this is, let's picture those lights. Probably, yeah. Super high voltage.
Well, the lights are there so that the terrorists can spot the big, beautiful, brave IDF vegan, yep, soldiers from afar and then take pot shots with a sniper rifle.
Invasion of the refugee camp, say the atmosphere is very reminiscent of that bloody episode when Israel killed over 60 Palestinians and basically pummeled the refugee camp, destroyed it, leveled many of its neighborhoods to the ground, also under the very similar pretenses.
You know, it's hard for us to get a read of what's going on the ground. We have live pictures right now of Jenin, as you can see, as the sun is setting, we still...
Yeah, refugee camp, not sure how that works when they are Palestinians in their own country. Maybe concentration camp is more precise. You know, relegating them to ghettos, you know, seems like that's what is happening. But yeah, it is. That is precisely what it is.
They are actively greenwashing already. The saga of Israeli water management is one of the most inspiring stories of the last 75 years. Israel went from having serious water problem to being a net water exporter to neighboring countries. Meanwhile, the population grew from 1 million to well over 9 million. 97% of Gaza's water is undrinkable. Like everything else about Israel, the displacement and murder of Palestinians is the reality that this greenwashing attempts to obscure.
Yeah.
They have so much water, they're giving it to neighbors, dude. Except, you know, not the people that used to live there that you displaced and kill all the time. Insane. But again, they're based. They don't want the gay-turning water. Palestinians, they want Palestinians to not turn gay with the water.
Oh,
that's what it is. That's why they deny them the vaccines. That's why they deny them modern medicine. That's why they deny them water. They deny Palestinians electricity so that they are not, like, mind-melted, like, brainwashed by TikToks. You know,
for Palestinians, these horrible scenes and these SOS calls from paramedics and from journalists and from residents of the refugee camp are part of a bigger and very violent picture of daily life under Israeli occupation. The Palestinians are ruled against their will by the Israelis, and in order to maintain that rule, which is violent in its nature, Israel conducts these campaigns against Palestinians Palestinian resistance, mm-hmm. which exists because the occupation is, exists. As you know, your reporter was reporting out of Ukraine a few moments ago and was talking about efforts to combat occupation there. It's pretty much the same when it comes to Palestinians. Unfortunately, the international reaction is very different.
And I want, our reporting says that the United States Biden administration is watching the situation closely, but it continues to hold the line, saying that Israel is entitled to safeguard its security. I also want to get to.
Oh my God, dude. Oh my God. You cannot say that. It's like, dude, the situation is equivalent to, like I said, a bunch of fucking military, like hopped up psychopathic reactionary cops walking into a fucking kindergarten or just driving an armored personnel carrier to the wall of a kindergarten and then slaughtering all the fucking children in there. Okay? You don't turn around and go, well, what about the cops' right to defend themselves? Okay? They have a right to safeguard themselves. It's like, you can't do that. That's an insane fucking take.
It's just
a
balance.
He needs to hold the line, saying that, look, Israel is entitled to safeguard its security. I also want to get to those calls from Hamas and Islamic Jihad to, in their words...
Yeah, what about Hamas and Islamic Jihad? Okay, what about them, dude? What do you want? What do they have? What does the Palestinian person have? What do they have for any kind of, like, even crumb of emancipation? Everyone always, like, Islamic Jihad and Hamas. First of all, Hamas, also an Israeli/American counterbalance to the more Marxist, more tolerant revolutionary, still armed revolutionary groups that originally were profoundly popular, but you butchered them. So now there's only the fundamentalists left, okay? And, you know, they're the only ones who are rising up in arms to defend themselves. What are you supposed to do? Every American loves fantasizing about how if some motherfucker came to my house, some perverts came to my house and, like, try to fuck my wife, like, I'd have my AR-15 and I'd shoot that fucker dead, you know what I mean? I have a right to defend myself, but, like, when it comes down to it, no Palestinian has a right to defend themselves against a brutal occupying force, okay? You can't do that. They're always like, nope, not like that. Don't do that. What about Hamas? What about Hamas? It's like, what do they have? They have nothing. They have nothing. Like, half the time when we talk about fucking rocket fire from Gaza into Israel, right? The worthy people, the people that are actually being blown away that people should care about, right? Every single time they talk about Hamas, where do they get the rockets from? Where? How are they making the rockets? They're making it with projectiles that Israel threw into Gaza, okay? It's not like they got fucking rocket scientists out there. It's not like they got, you know, a litany of natural resources to build from. It's not like they have a steady flow of shit coming into fucking Gaza. They're literally making handmade rockets off of the fucking rockets that you shot down into Gaza. And all of those rockets are ultimately intercepted. Almost all of them are intercepted. You know how? Because I'm a taxpaying U.S. citizen and I pay for the Iron Dome. So, like, I literally have already, I'm already defending Israel every goddamn day with my taxes, okay? I have, time and time again, said we should sell to both sides. Like, if Israel gets an Iron Dome, Palestine, across the board, okay? Palestinians deserve Stingray missiles or Stinger missiles. They deserve a howitzer launching system. They deserve an Iron Dome of themselves. You double up on the money. Just give them the Iron Dome too. Give them HIMARS. Treat it like Ukraine, you know what I mean? Fucking bullshit. Are Palestinians just supposed to sit there forever until they're granted rights by an occupying force? Yeah, that's exactly right. Like, what are they supposed to do? They're like, what about Hamas? What about Hamas? Like, yeah, I'm sorry that, like, you know, the only people that have, like, an armed form, like the only people that are basically the functional government of an open-air prison that Israel manages happen to be fundamentalists and are not, like, woke for you, okay? And by that same logic, like, Ukraine doesn't meet that metric either, but you don't give a fuck when you see the black sun on every fucking military patch on Ukrainian soldiers, because it doesn't matter, because it's, like, more manageable because they're white. That is an armed emancipation cause that you are on board with. You don't care.
What about Russia's right to self-defense?
Nazis equals Islamists? No, that's not what I'm saying, man. Shut the fuck up. Like, you're leaping here, okay? First of all, if Nazis equaled Islamists, I'm sure the US media wouldn't have that much of a problem with fucking fundamentalists, okay?
they would be like, no, these guys are awesome. You can't look at this as a as like, oh, what are their politics in this regard? Oh, what are their personal perspectives here? It's the government, dog. What are you supposed to do? Think about it this way. America shot down the fucking Chinese balloon like a couple months back, okay? Because some dumbass balloon drifted over U.S. airspace, okay, on accident. Think about that. That's what the government is supposed to do. The government's supposed to protect you, right? So what the fuck is Hamas supposed to do if they're the government? They're supposed to protect you from Israeli missile attacks, okay? They're supposed to retaliate. That's what they're doing. That's the government, dog. That's, of course they're gonna do that.
Strike Israel by all available means to stop the massacre.
Yeah, and their available means are just fucking kites that they put, like incendiary, like the little bit of incendiary fuel that they can find on those kites so they can, like, try to fucking fling the kite over the border wall so it can, like, drop on crops, dude. Oh my God. Oh my fucking God. How devastating. How terrifying.
I mean, how much of a tipping point are we at here in terms of an escalation, especially, you know, all available means basically is a call to action for more violence, is it not?
Like, if you want to stop Hamas's power, or if you want to stop Palestinian attacks, stop fucking making more radicalized babies who are going to understandably want to take up arms against this unlawful, unjust, and cruel apartheid state that's occupying their land. Like, why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you want to fucking grab a gun and defend yourself? It is the most honest, most just, most understandable reaction to watching your fucking baby cousin get blown to bits in her crib, okay? You see that shit, you're not going to be the same ever again. You look at a situation where every single child, every single Palestinian child has PTSD. Every single one. What are they supposed to do? How is it supposed to stop? How is the hurt supposed to stop in any other way? It's not like they can ask kindly, and if they do ask kindly, Israel will go, fuck, man. I didn't realize how bad things were. I didn't realize we were sitting in Sidarot Cinema, propping fucking couches on hilltops to watch with binoculars as Israeli snipers sniped down 14-year-olds. I didn't realize that was morally unhinged, okay?
If you look at mass media, the story you find is that they fire hundreds of rockets into Israeli cities right across the border. Everything before that point is left out. Most commonly, we hear of rockets hitting the border city of Sderot. It is home to the notorious Sderot Cinema, where settlers drink beer and eat popcorn watching bombs fall onto Gaza.
Didn't realize that. My bad. I didn't realize that it was fucked up to watch Palestinian babies get blown to fucking bits by U.S.-backed artillery, okay? Air support and artillery and all this technology that we are also helping Israel utilize and deploy on unsuspecting Palestinian babies. I didn't realize watching that shit like it was fireworks was actually kind of unhinged, genocidal, bloodthirsty. I didn't realize it was like that. I thought it was kind of tight that we were doing that. You were traumatizing your guys? Bro, acting like Palestinians don't do the same thing. Yeah, Palestinians, dude. Yeah, dude, it's so crazy. Yeah, 14-year-old Palestinians deploying missile strikes into different parts of Israel. It's, you know, they're always just like, they're flying. The Palestinian Air Force, Gaza Air Brigade Commander Mahmoud is fucking flying a plane over Tel Aviv and just deploying artillery and bombs on the beaches. Also famously backed by the U.S. military, of course. Palestinians have those extremely sophisticated NATO weapons. If a Palestinian ever acquires a NATO weapon, it's because some dumbass Israeli soldier dropped it, okay? That's the only way they're getting that shit. Let's be fucking real.